Hey, Light 105. I think it is really amazing what you're doing here with your 100 subs contest. I myself have 61 subs, so I know exactly what you're talking about when you say it's hard to get to 100. Collecting kind of began when I was really, really young. I grew up an only child, so and I also grew up out in the country. So I didn't have a lot of people around me. Also, I grew up Jewish, so yeah, that kind of alienates people as well for some reason. My grandmother spoiled the hell out of me. She bought me pretty much just a ton of action figures. I had figures, it didn't matter. I was not gonna get bored as a kid. And as you get older, you get 12, 13, definitely in your teens, I was not, these figures were stored away in a box. They were stored away in a box and put in a garage and just pretty much forgot about them, which is really sad now that I look around me. What really got me back into collecting was my wife and I were living in Dallas, Texas, and there was a Toys R Us right nearby. I mean, 1 minute away. So we drove down there to actually buy our friend a video game for Christmas or their birthday or something. And I decided, hey, I'm gonna stop by the toy aisle. So I went by the toy aisle, and I hadn't been in a toy aisle since I was a child. And I see a Nightcrawler. Now, I know you don't know me, but for those who do, they know that Nightcrawler is what I live and breathe for collecting or comics. I'll tell you what, since he died in comics, I'm sure Marvel's stock has dropped a bit. When I walked into the toy aisle and saw that Nightcrawler, I realized how movable he was. The articulation was insane. I couldn't believe it. So I had money, I had a job. I was like, hey, I'm gonna buy this thing just to bring home. And I took him out of the package when I got to the house, and I was completely blown away. From that spawned this insane want to start collecting figures. I would go back every now and then and check on more and check on more, and I found a face-off Iron Man pack at retail. Luckily, when I started collecting, Toy Biz was still going, but they were dropping out, which pains me to think about how many amazing figures that I've overspent on, but I wouldn't trade anything that I have in my room. But that's how I pretty much got into collecting. And then from collecting, you start collecting more figures. From there, I noticed that there were a lot of figures that weren't made. So I found a whole different world in customizing. Customizing, to me, I mean, it's made me money. It's actually paid a few bills. It's a great hobby. Being a Nightcrawler fan, I've made already 10 customs of him. Because some of them I feel weren't good enough. The head sculpt that they gave on the Marvel Legends 9 Galactus series Nightcrawler was atrocious. I felt the need to just make my characters that were my favorites, better. And I feel like I've succeeded in that. But just knowing that now I can, just from collecting one figure, stemming this entire world. And then Facebook, of course, gets bigger. And I find out about the ACBA group from my friend John Paul Martinez, who I'd actually done a custom for by meeting him on Marvelous News. And he saw some of the work I was doing and he asked for a figure. We became really good friends. And then years later, he tells me about ACBA. And I check out ACBA, and then I found out there's this entire YouTube world. And I mean, obviously I knew about YouTube, but I didn't know this was like this these there's so many of us out there. It's insane how many there actually are of us. I mean, we're the reason that these are where they are, and how popular they are, and probably how expensive they've gotten. But it's just really encouraging and really amazing, and it just I mean, some people could probably be embarrassed by things. It's like, oh my gosh, I'm still I wouldn't say playing with toys because I can't play with these guys anymore. I don't have that in me. That part of the childhood is gone. But being able to open this like window, this conduit to all these figures that you can just you can get, you can display, You know, you get your playtime in by posing, is the way I see it. You know, I mean, if you want to play with your figures, go crazy, have fun. But it's amazing to me, the amount of people that are involved in this. And then seeing ACBA, I've gotten to know Boog Nice very well. He's a great guy, and what he's done and what they've created in the ACBA community to me is absolutely amazing. And I believe the YouTube community and the ACBA community and just the entire collecting community as a whole, we're worldwide. We make all this go around, obviously, and I couldn't be more happy to be a part of it. That's really my two cents. I appreciate you taking the time to listen to me, to my rant, and I wish the luck to everybody on the subscriptions contest. Light, I think it's amazing what you've done here, and I congratulate you on 100, and I guarantee you by the end of this, you will definitely be over 200. So get ready for another contest. All right, we'll see you later. Just so I don't forget, I am in the over 18 bracket. As you can tell from this mighty beard made out of fire and awesome.